What's going on, everybody? Brandon here. Another quick painting video today based off of some of these Monarch butterflies that I did on a larger painting earlier. We're going to have a real-time look at doing one of these little guys, small canvas Monarch butterfly. Let's get to it. Alright, the first thing we're going to do is just put our background in. I'm going to be using a 3/4 inch flat brush for this. I'm also just going to be using some yellow ochre, some sap green, a little bit of a bright green, and a white. And we're just going to go into some of this green, mix in some yellow ochre, a little bit of the white. Just start to brush this color in. And some variation in this color is good, you know, brighter areas, darker areas. We're making it look like a out of focus, distant patch of flowers and grass back there, so you don't want it all looking the same. And of course, our butterfly is going to be largely through the center of this, so I don't have to worry about getting all this middle area anyway. I'm going to put a few things in that are going to give the indication that there's maybe a stem of some sort back there. Now, if you want to put the idea that there's maybe some flowers back there, they're a little bit out of focus as well, you can go into any number of colors. You can go into reds or purples or blues or whatever you like. I'm going to put just a touch of Quinacridone Magenta on here with some white and just kind of touch it in a place or two here and there. And I'm going to do the same thing with just a hint of bright purple. I think that'll work. Now we're going to pencil sketch in a butterfly here. And actually, I think I want to take this top line of our flower, our distant flowers, down just a little further. So let's bring this down a little bit. A little better. Now let's put a butterfly in here, and I'm just going to basically sketch it an outline. And I don't want him perfectly lined up straight with the canvas. I'm going to put him in here a little bit of an angle, something about like that probably. So let's go with the top of the head somewhere right in maybe here. And we'll carry a wing out this direction. Alright, so I can already tell I need to cover up a little bit more, obviously, in my background there, which is fine. We'll go back into that same mix of green and some yellow ochre, maybe a touch of white. And we'll just put some more of that in. Right. Now we've just got a basic outline of where we're going to stick our butterfly in there. We're going to do a monarch butterfly here, so I'm going to use the same color mix that we've had out here with this yellow ochre, but I'm going to add some brown and black to it. So I'm going to be using a little 1/8 inch angled brush for this, and I'm going to go into the burnt umber and some ivory black along with the yellow ochre we've been using to create a pretty dark value that's kind of looks like black, but it's not just pure black, obviously, because we don't want just straight black on the canvas. And that's what we're going to trace the outline here of our monarch butterfly with. Now he's gonna have a head that pokes up here, up into that vicinity somewhere. Trace the tops of the wings out. Thank you. Now that I've got my basic butterfly outline there, I'm going to put a little bit of a flower up here in front of him that he's going to be sitting on. Since I use some of this purple back here, I'm just going to stick with the purple. I'm going to use a little small spotter brush for this. I'm going to go back into that bright purple that I had. Mix in just a hint of just a touch of black with it and a touch of that burnt umber with it to gray it out a little bit. And I'm going to come back in here and yeah, we'll make a kind of a round looking thing here. Now we need to come back in with lighter values of that purple. Something like that. That'll give us the illusion that he is sitting there feeding on something. Maybe I want to take just a little bit of this Quinacridone Magenta that I had and put it into our purple mix. Bring that into some of this area right down closer to where the butterfly's face is going to be sitting, just to give it a little bit of depth to the flower right there. Now I need to get started putting some color in on our butterfly. We're mostly going to cover this thing out initially with an orange that I'm going to create with just a yellow ochre. And while I've got this magenta out here, we'll use some of that as well. Okay, after giving that a minute to dry, now I'm going to clean up some of my edges, the outer edges of this butterfly with that mix that we used to create that dark, almost black, but not quite black. So again, just raw umber, black, some of that yellow ochre. Now we need to draw these lines that are in here on these wings. And you don't have to be exact on this if you're doing a monarch, but I try to keep it fairly close looking at some reference photos because these butterflies mostly have the same patterns and they might vary slightly. Alright, now before we get to drawing the lines in here that these butterflies have, I want to finish out my orange underneath and get it the way I want it looking, and then put the black lines underneath. So all I'm going to do here on this orange is I'm going to keep some of the areas on the tips of the wings a little darker and up in here a little darker. I'm going to lighten up some of this in here just to kind of give it a little bit more of a realistic appearance, and so it's not so monotone looking. So I'm going to bring some cadmium orange into this mix to give me a little brighter value of orange. If you don't have cadmium orange, you can just lighten up your values of your yellow ochre and either medium red or the magenta. If you've got that, you can bring in some white to lighten it up a little bit. In fact, I might do some of that first. So the same mix that we had, I'll just bring in just a little bit of titanium white to it. And we'll come in here mostly along this body. I'm bringing a little cadmium orange into this mix. Thank you. Now let's get started putting these lines in here on these wings. I'm gonna go back to my small spotter brush. And again, use a reference photo here to get these relatively close. Doesn't have to be perfect. Now with my small spotter brush, I'm going to add in a little bit more highlight into the orange areas of these wings by brightening up the value a little bit more into some areas, just to add just that last little touch of bright highlight in there in some of these places. Yeah, we need to start adding these little white dots that are around these edges. And we don't want pure white, so I'm going to add just a hint of yellow ochre into the mix to cream it out just a little. And these can be relatively random, but for the most part, they do seem to be kind of symmetrical from one side to the other. Alright, our butterfly is pretty much finished. I think I'm going to drop in some kind of stem coming down here that belongs to that flower up there, and then maybe another piece of one coming off of the edge over here, just to make it look like that flower blossom up there is not just hovering in the middle of space. So I'm going to just get some green, a little bit of a little bit of raw umber to darken it up some, and drop in a few highlights, some brighter green in here on it. That's about it. Now to give ourselves maybe a little bit more of the purple hanging off, let's come in Now one last pass of cleaning up some of these lines. We'll call that a finished product. Hopefully you guys enjoyed painting along with that one and got a nice butterfly painting out of it that you're happy with. Until next time, take care, everybody.